Hi everyone! Kumusta po kayong lahat? This is Rupert Jordan. Welcome back to my channel, English for Millennials, a conversational English for non-native speakers. I would like to give a big shout out to the following: Mary Paul, Honey Bunny Cheche, King Jacob, Ginang Sai, and their support team, Joy Sweden, Jessa Billiones, Pro Vlog, Senior Blog, E. Huason, Nelly Lowe, NC Melly, Jane Boliena and team, Dynamite Effect and Bluetooth Family, thank you for supporting and promoting my vlog and channel. And of course, to all YouTubers, bloggers, too many to mention your names, who like my post, leave your comments, share my video, and subscribe to my channel. Maraming marami pong salamat sa inyong lahat. You are always remembered in my prayers. God bless you po. Today, I will discuss about how to build a solid language foundation. This is what you exactly see in the logo of this channel, the three important blocks in learning English for millennials: social media, linguistic components, and Howard Gardner's multiple intelligences. The first block, the power of social media. Why are social media very powerful nowadays? Research shows that one big factor influencing students' performance is the access to the internet and social media. Why? It is simply because it can offer us a number of ways to learn easier and faster at a very low cost, and give students better options to quality education. There are social media platforms that serve as their virtual classrooms, bringing learning institutions available to all people from all walks of life. Prices range from free to affordable and highly paid online courses. However, our team decides to give lessons for free, since we believe that language is a gift from God. Thus, we also share our knowledge and experiences for free. Almost all lessons prepared by well-experienced mentors and coaches are now available via YouTube, Facebook, Twitter, Tumblr, Instagram, and other leading social media platforms by just clicking like, comments, share, and subscribe. Membership is done instantly. This is how powerful and effective social media now. The second block, linguistic components. We do believe that linguistic components are very important for both mentors and learners. First, it helps us mentors convey the origin, the individual sound, and the study of language pronunciation or phonology, formations and unit of words or morphology, the arrangement of words and phrases to make a well-constructed sentence or syntax, the meaning of words, phrase, or text, we call it semantics, and the historical application and modern-day relevance on use of words in different contexts, such as conversation, organization, areas of specialization, and so on, and we call it pragmatics. Lastly, combining all these components together as one approach to teaching language really helps students gain a better, more in-depth understanding of their assignments, projects, and work product expectations, and provide a much stronger language foundation. On phonetics and phonology, I'll provide you the American and British pronunciations with the standard phonetic symbols. The priority for the first entry is the sound in the general American English, and the second one is the British English. For example, L-E-A-R-N can be pronounced in two ways. In American is learn, but in British is learn. Always remember that in spoken British, The final ras sound of a word or a syllable is always omitted but retained in American English. On morphology, formation of words will be highlighted as you can see in this example. The infinitive to learn can be conjugated into learn, learns, learned, or learned, and learning. On syntax, the arrangement and order of words is always emphasized in all lessons, particularly topics on tenses, moods and voice of the verb, kinds of sentences, and modifiers. For example, still I'm using the verb learn. Jane learns English at school. Another way is, English is learned or learned by Jane at school. On semantics, vocabulary is discussed as separate activities in the book. Lastly, on pragmatics, the application of words and phrases are emphasized in the conversation and interaction parts. As you can see in my example, I will flash on the screen. The last block, the theory of multiple intelligences. As I have emphasized on my previous blog, Howard Gardner, an American developmental psychologist and the originator of this theory, believes that every person possesses different kinds of minds or intelligences, and therefore he learns, remembers, performs, and understands in different ways. Conventionally, the multiple intelligences are language or word smart. As I mentioned, the particular MI, skills and possible professions are flashed on the screen. Please find your areas of intelligences. Logic, math or number smart. Naturalistic or nature smart. Musical or music smart. Kinesthetic or body smart. Visual or picture smart. Interpersonal or people smart. Intrapersonal or self smart. And others, which are still on debate, particularly spiritual intelligences. In classroom settings, the multiple intelligences are very useful tools and powerful modes of learning. We always try to become optimistic about the students. We always let the individual capacity as power to rule them by helping them overcome their weaknesses and by boasting their talents to improve poor performance. In other words, we will try to modify negative attitudes and behaviors or behavior modification or any handicapping conditions that impede learning a language. When you successfully build a strong language foundation, you will achieve a degree of fluency from functional beginner to conversational to advanced to fluent till you reach native speaker level. Congratulations. Furthermore, having a solid language foundation will help you become successful, effective communicators as well as build your confidence and overall sense of well-being. A piece of advice to our young generations or the millennials when it comes to learning a language. Remember that all words are not equal. Learning some types of words will accelerate your progress more quickly than learning other types of words. To be most effective in learning a language, focus on the most common words in line with your multiple intelligences before starting to study more specialized vocabularies. And learn the most common definitions first instead of trying to memorize every definition. Believe in me. Here ends up my presentation for today. Thank you for watching. Once again, this is Rupert Jordan inviting everyone to stay tuned to this channel. Please do subscribe us. If you have not yet clicked the button below, click like, leave your comments, Share this video with your families and friends and hit the notification bell for the latest updates. May God bless you.